question about the fact that the president went around the country for several weeks this summer talking about phony scandals, and you don't have to scratch very far in the White House to find people who say this is just...
This is it.
This is a partisan effort by Republicans to exploit a tragedy. Do you agree with that?
Yeah. I think there's... Look, there's not one shred of evidence that the White House knew about this beforehand,
that
they covered up anything.
Knew about what?
Knew about this attack. Oh, there are all sorts of allegations up on the Hill coming from Republicans.
I don't hear that.
You know what? What really drives me is you've had an accountability review board come in, make 29 recommendations. State Department has accepted just about every one of them.
The review board never even spoke to the Secretary of State.
Look, the Secretary of State at the time, Hillary Clinton, has testified on Capitol Hill.
And dismissed the whole
issue. Let me just make one other point. The big argument coming from Republicans for most of this time was there was a stand-down order given from Washington or from the military command that we could have gone in and saved those people, but the stand-down order was given. Well, now we have Lieutenant Colonel Gibson, who was in charge of special forces in Libya, saying no stand down order was ever given.
They just told him not to go. They didn't call it a stand down order.
Oh, okay. So in other words, then we don't have anything. A year later, we do have an indictment, and Eric Holder, the Attorney General, has said more is coming shortly. But to make a scandal out of this, it really, that's why you say this is not going away. Let me tell you, this has gone away.
No, it hasn't. The American people were lied to. Somebody concocted a deliberate lie that this was all the response. This was not a terrorist attack. This was a spontaneous reaction to a video that no one saw. The American people have a legitimate question. Why were efforts not undertaken to save our people?
That the efforts were made.
No, they weren't.
Let's go back to your first point.
They were simply not. With all due respect, no assets were put in motion.
And as you just admitted,
U.S. military on the ground in Tripoli were told, don't go to Benghazi.
No, there was no stand-on order according. What we have is, don't go in after the fact when we don't know what you're getting into, and it could result in more American deaths.
Go. Don't go. That's the important thing.
No.
Do not go.
The difference,
and remember what that Marine said. Remember what he said. He said it was the first time in history that he could remember that a member of the U.S. Foreign Service had more cojones than somebody in the military, and
that's
he was embarrassed.
Carl, you're all in the weeds here. The key point
is the death of four Americans and why no one went to their aid is not in the weeds.
What's in the weeds is the fact that you continue to prosecute this like there's some huge crime.
A deliberate lie to the American people.
Stop living in the past and trying to get after Susan Rice or whoever. This has nothing to do with the death of Ambassador Stevens.
Susan Rice or whoever. We don't know who is responsible for lying to the American people.
You
may be comfortable with the American people being told a deliberate lie by the administration, but I'm not, and I think that we need to get to the bottom of it.
Why was no effort made to save those American people? It does not speak to the heart of the issue.
Chris, clearly this is not over, as evidenced by the emotions at this table 1 year later.
And one more thing. Think of the list of, going around this table here, the list of questions that remain unanswered to this day are what make this still a legitimate topic for conversation. And meanwhile, I'm sorry to say that this is simply not over.
It's gone, baby. It's in your head. That's about the only place.